What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose we are given an m times n integer matrix with the following properties. Each row is sorted from left to right, and the first integer of each row is greater than the last integer of the previous row. What we need to do is write an algorithm to search for a given target value inside this matrix, return true if the target value exists, and false if it doesn't. Searching inside a matrix is always represented with two nested loops, and maybe that's what most of you will be trying to do first. However, you see, this piece of code, even though concise, runs in quadratic time complexity, and I assure you that is not the kind of logic you want to be using to search for an element. So, how can we search for a given target element in this matrix in a more optimal manner? Well, if you've watched the previous videos of this series, you may recall the binary search technique. And as a reminder, binary search allows us to search for a specific value in a sorted collection or a sorted array in logarithmic time complexity. Now, some of you may say, yes, let's go ahead and transform this matrix into a big sorted array, because that's what it is, and then apply binary search on that array. Well, this is not going to do us any good. You see, to build this big array, we will need to traverse all the elements of the matrix, and this requires n squared time, so our complexity is still the same. What you can do, on the other hand, is take each row separately and apply binary search on it, because each row individually is also a sorted array, right? So, in our n squared implementation, we have two loops, one traversing the rows and one traversing the columns or the elements inside each row. And that second loop is the one we will be replacing. You see, instead of traversing each element inside each row individually, what we can do is check if the target element we are looking for is inside the row in question, and then go ahead and apply binary search on that row and return with the result of the binary search method. I am going to throw in the binary search implementation as is, since we previously implemented it on several occasions, but feel free to check the card above for a detailed explanation on how it is done. Okay, by doing that, we managed to reduce our complexity to O of n. Why linear and not n log n? Well, because we are still going through all the rows, but we are stopping as soon as we find a row, and this row is being searched logarithmically, making our overall complexity O of n plus O of log n, which can be reduced to O of n. So, do you think we can reduce this complexity further? Well, yes, we can. You see, this same logic we applied on columns can be applied on rows. And the beauty is, we don't need all rows, just the first row and the last one. Why? Think about it. These rows ultimately represent an array. Okay, an array of arrays, but still an array. And not any array, a sorted array, because the arrays inside it are sorted among each other. Meaning we can apply binary search on this array of arrays, or the array of rows, to locate the potential single row that may be holding our target value in log of n time. And the condition that will help us do that is check if the value of the target is between the value of the first row and the value of the last one. So our initial method code will look something like this. We will first attempt to retrieve the row in question with the help of binary search in a logarithmic time. Then, if that row exists, we will attempt to binary search it with the help of the previous method we wrote and return with the result. This new implementation is logarithmic in time and is the optimal solution to our problem. Now, before moving on, let's implement together this getRow method. It is a classic binary search implementation, as you can see. However, the middle element we calculate will always be pointing to the index of the row in the matrix. The right reference is moved if the first element of the middle row is bigger than the target, the left reference is moved if the last element of the middle row is smaller than the target element, and a row is returned when the target integer is located between its first and last elements. Okay, after solving this problem, if the interviewer is looking to really scale things up, they might modify one property of the two we previously had. You see, the rows will still be sorted individually, but not among other rows. And this time, the columns are also sorted from top to bottom, and we still need to find a given target value. The solution we wrote that applies binary search on each row individually will work here with a small modification, as you can see in front of you. We will have to apply the binary search on all rows and cannot return as soon as we find one row, because the target value we are looking for might be in several rows and is not restricted to one as we previously had, making the complexity of this logic O of n log n. Additionally, the last optimal solution we wrote that also applies binary search to retrieve one specific row will not work as the rows are not sorted among themselves. So, to modify this property and ask this new question, the interviewer is basically looking to improve on the n log n solution we wrote. But how do we do that? Well, there is something we can do that does not involve binary search, but to come up with it, you really must take a closer look at the matrix to notice one particular property. You see, these two corners are surrounded by smaller and bigger elements. This one only has bigger elements, and that one only has smaller elements. But how having a smaller and a bigger element helps us? Well, we will be able to write something like this. So, for example, if we start at this corner, at this element, compare it to our target and deduce that it is smaller than the target, which let's assume is 11 for now, then we only have one path to walk, and it is going to the right. None other, one single choice. Same applies if the element we are at is bigger than the target, then we have a single path to walk, and it is up. If we keep doing this, we will eventually reach the element we are looking for, or conclude that it doesn't exist in the matrix. On top of that, the same logic can be applied to the second corner we mentioned. And by doing this, we reduce our complexity to big O of m plus n in its worst case if we had to traverse the whole matrix. And that's it. The link to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comment section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.